Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today we're taking a look at Hell Let Loose. It's a tactical World War II shooter with tons of maps, weapons, and a pretty brutal damage model. It was initially funded on Kickstarter in 2017 to the tune of $220,000. Between then and 2019, it was available to backers as a series of alphas and betas before launching on Steam Early Access on June 6th, 2019. Now, of course, one can't help comparing Hell Let Loose to Battlefield 5. They're both large-scale infantry combat games set in World War II. Right off the bat, though, I think it's safe to say that they're wildly different games. Battlefield, as a franchise, has tactical elements as part of its DNA, but at its heart, it's more of a sandbox arcade shooter. Battlefield 5 certainly tried to lean more towards tactical stuff with the interaction animations, attrition, and pre-5.2 damage mode, but by and large, it's certainly not a game reliant on teammates for having fun and engaging combat experiences. Hell Let Loose, on the other hand, is very much a tactical shooter. Squad positioning, role selection, map control, and teamwork are all top priorities, regardless of your mechanical skill. You can be an aim god in Hell Let Loose, but it's not going to do much for your team. If you don't work together as a cohesive unit with your squad and team, you'll end up stuck at the enemy front lines, unable to flank or gain ground. It can feel pretty brutal when things go sideways. But on the other hand, when things do go well, they feel extremely earned and highly rewarding. So, what are the basics of Hell Let Loose? There are two different modes to play, Warfare and Offensive. For Battlefield 5 players, think of Warfare like Breakthrough and Offensive like Conquest Assault. In both modes, the map is divided into sectors. Both teams fight to control these sectors. In Warfare, both teams fight to control sectors and push the other team back. Whoever has the most sectors when the timer runs out or captures all the sectors wins the game. In Offensive, the defending team holds all sectors and the attackers need to capture all of them in order to win. Each team has several main squads of infantry, two vehicle squads, and two recon squads. The main infantry squads have access to a variety of kits like medic, assault, anti-tank, engineer, etc. Each one serves a different role and has specific weapon options. The vehicle squads are basically the tank support crew, and the recon squads each get one sniper and one spotter. Now, the only way to get an optic for your weapon is to play as the sniper role. Considering there's only two per team, this is a highly coveted role. Most of the maps are wide open countrysides, so being able to engage targets at range gives you a huge advantage. On the Omaha Beach map, for example, everyone but the sniper is basically stuck taking pot shots at the entrenched defenders. As for how the spawn system works, both teams have to manually build spawn points as they traverse the map. You can build squad spawn points or garrisons. Anyone on your team can spawn on a garrison, while the squad spawns are, as suggested by the name, limited to your squad. Garrisons are crucial to maintaining a line of attack or defense. Without a well-positioned one, your team is basically done for. That said, there's no ticket or limit on how many times you can respawn, so going for long flanks to build garrisons on enemy flanks is well worth the effort, even if you end up dying several times. To be honest, that's kind of the general experience of Hell Let Loose. You're gonna die. A lot. Unless you're super patient and stick with your squad. Which, to be honest, I'm not always that good at. Bullets seem to be constantly flying all over the place, with objectives far apart and not much cover between them, moving around as a solo player can be a bit of a nightmare. But that's part of what makes the team play so compelling. In Battlefield, a good flank will net you a few kills, maybe you'll flip an objective. If you're lucky, some squad mates will spawn on you, but the rest of your team will be off in La La Land doing their own thing, and your contribution will probably get erased once the enemies you've killed respawn. Battlefield has a consistent ebb and flow to it that makes it fun and fast-paced, but that fast-paced nature also takes away from every little thing that you do leading up to the final moments of a match. In Hell Let Loose, it's those little things you do throughout the match that can have huge consequences. Knowing your entire team is depending on you to get a good position and build a spawn point creates stakes and tensions that most other games just don't offer in their moment-to-moment combat. So when you combine the stakes and hardcore gunplay, Hell Let Loose can prove to be a pretty rewarding and exciting game. On top of that, the general sense of atmosphere and immersion is really top-notch on some maps. It's difficult to convey in a video, but the game just has that World War II grit that makes running through a shallow river, down an enemy trench, across an open field extremely exciting. The graphics are quite good for an indie title, but also the scale and locational accuracy really lends itself to the believability of your environment. It's frustrating that the game doesn't run better on high settings, though, as turning things up to max really does improve the overall look. Perhaps some optimization passes in the future can get us there. But honestly, so far so good, right? I mean, there's gotta be some glaring issues holding Hell Let Loose back from greatness, otherwise I assume everybody would be playing it. Well, there sort of is, but it's one of those things that usually goes hand in hand with making an indie tactical shooter. See, the thing most of these tactical shooters get wrong is the little stuff. Hell Let Loose has a bunch of small UI issues that you run into constantly. When you die, you get kicked to a screen that says you died. You have to wait about 10 seconds before you can move on from that screen, which you then have to do manually. Then you have to pick a spawn point and wait upwards of 30 seconds to spawn. And even selecting a spawn point can be frustrating because when you're grouped up, it doesn't prioritize the one you can actually spawn on. You have to zoom in, which doesn't work if the cursor is over something you can click on. So you have to move the mouse, zoom in, then click spawn point, then click deploy. And if you don't do all that stuff right before the spawn timer resets, you have to wait for it to count down again before you can spawn. Dealing with all of that every single time you die does get frustrating after a while. Battlefield 5's response system certainly isn't ideal, but after several hours of Hell Let Loose, it'll seem like a streamlined dream by comparison. Once your boots are on the ground is where another common tactical shooter issue pops up. Movement. Now, again, Battlefield is notorious for players getting stuck on curbs, rocks, pebbles, and figments of your imagination, but in Hell Let Loose, you feel like you're wading through the muck all the time. It's not too bad, the devs certainly have done a better job than some other games, but it could feel more snappy and responsive. You could certainly draw a comparison to the movement in Hell Let Loose to, say, PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds. Your characters just feel slow, and everything they do seems to take forever. Climbing over stuff in particular has some jankiness to it. Once you've climbed something, more often than not, your character will just come to a dead stop, and you have to hit the move key again to continue. I'm not saying Hell Let Loose should feel like a twitchy arcade shooter or anything, but movement in shooters has come so far in the past 10 years, and a lot of tactical shooters feel like they're 15-year-old games when it comes to this department. Hell Let Loose feels a little bit more modern than that, but it could be snappier, more intuitive without ruining the core design. One issue that seems perhaps overly aggravating in Hell Let Loose is the limited class design. Sure, we don't want snipers running all over the place, but at the same time, getting picked off over and over again by players you can't even see to return fire on gets old pretty fast. And if the snipers on your team aren't doing their job, well, then you're out of luck. There are times while playing that I'd kill for an optic on my gun. Literally. Like, I wish you could kill a sniper and pick up their weapon, but dead players don't drop weapons you can pick up, so you're basically stuck with whatever you have in your hands at spawn. Now, obviously, I'm aware that a lot of this is because of the game's design and balance. As infantry, you're basically cannon fodder used by the vehicle and recon squads to flood objectives with bodies and provide spawn locations. You're not supposed to be a super effective long-range marksman. The issue, of course, is I know I could be better if I just had a basic 3x optic. It's like being a grunt while other players get to play the hero classes. And I do get the game concept, but at the same time, I still think there's room for more roles to have optics without breaking the game's balance. The suppression is also pretty brutal in Hell Let Loose. When suppressed, your aim gets jerked in random directions. It's also really hard to see, and it takes forever to fade away. Even with a sniper optic, suppression basically makes your gun useless until it goes away. When it comes to sound design, Hell Let Loose is pretty convincing, but the positional audio leaves a lot to be desired. Gunshots sound like they're right next to you even when the shooter is 25 meters away. Locating tanks by ear is also extremely difficult. They create almost a wall of noise that sounds like it's coming from everywhere in a general direction. The sounds themselves are fine, it's really more of a positional and distance related issue. And then finally on the list of critiques against this game, there's the performance. Getting above 60 FPS on anything but medium or low settings is an effort in futility. It's a shame because, again, on high settings, the game looks very good. At low settings, though, there's a ton of object popping and ugly lighting stuff that can be distracting. The difference between high and low is much more dramatic than, say, Battlefield 5 or Insurgency Sandstorm. The game is still in early access, though, and optimization is generally the last phase of development for video games, so hopefully the devs will make inroads with performance as they approach the end of their early access phase. The Steam page says that the game will be in early access for a year, and it originally launched last June, so hopefully the full launch happens sometime this summer. Ultimately, I think Hell Let Loose is a really promising game. It certainly falls into the typical tactical shooter tropes, but if that's your thing, then the immersion and realism will carry you the rest of the way. Again, the immersion is hard to convey via YouTube, but it's a different experience when you're in the game. The developers have also announced some very promising things. The next update launches soon and will fix spawn location legibility and improve loading times for the game's latest map, among others. Alongside the update, they'll be revealing an updated roadmap for the game. On the slate for future updates are optimizations, a rework of the game's animations, transport vehicles, new character models, and more. Let me know what you guys think of Hell Let Loose in the comments down below, and if you want to see more of it. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.